Hi, I'm Cynthia from Brazil, and I really liked the course. I think the highlights were the new ideas of activities with tools I had already been using with my students, but with the course I got to know and think about different ways I could use these tools, and also new possibilities of tools that I could use with my students, both in class and both as extra activities for them to improve their skills. The five tools I decided to talk about were Flipgrid, Vocaroo, Kahoot, English Speaking Practice, and HelloTalk. Well, in fact, Flipgrid and Kahoot were tools that I had already used many times with my students, but after the course, I decided to use them again based on the experiences we had. So for the first week of my course this year, I used Flipgrid for the students to introduce themselves, just like we did on week one of this course. But I had a problem, I don't know why, because I had already used Flipgrid before. But they have this new function that connects with Google Classroom, so I decided to use this new function and I created the activity connected to Google Classroom. And what happened is that many students reported they could not join Flipgrid using the code or the link that I had shared in Google Classroom. I really don't know what happened, because two students managed to do it in Flipgrid, but as many other students were saying they couldn't, and I decided to share the links in different ways. I don't know what happened, they didn't manage to do it, so I decided to use Padlet. That is a tool that I also use a lot. So I told them the ones that could not access Flipgrid, they could do it in Padlet. So it was not as fun as it should be in Flipgrid, as we have the video. In Padlet, they decided to use the audio only, not the video. But they did the activity, they introduced themselves, which was the purpose, right? But I really don't know. I'll try to find out, because Flipgrid is a great tool. I would like to use it more often with my students. And maybe I'll try using it without the connection with Google Classroom, just sharing the link without this connection. Well, the second two was Vocaroo, which I had already heard about, but I had never used before. But after we used this, I saw how simple and easy it was. So for week two of my course, I used this tool for students to share their opinions on a topic that we had discussed during that week, that was language and culture. So I prepared some questions and I asked them to record an audio with their opinion on the question. So they had to reflect on the questions and then share their opinions with the audio. I still haven't corrected that activity yet, but I did not get any messages, so I believe it worked well. The third tool was Kahoot, which I had been using for some time, but I really liked the introduction activity we had in week one. So I used the one I created for week one with my students for our first class this semester, and they really enjoyed it. So it was a way for them to get to know me a little bit better. And I plan to use these tools throughout the semester for review and also to engage students at the beginning of the class, because I think it's a really interesting. They liked it a lot, although the focus was not really for them to speak, but it's really an engaging tool. The other two tools I decided to talk about is English Speaking Practice and HelloTalk, which are two tools I had never heard about before and I really liked them. For English Speaking Practice, students can listen to dialogues, and there is a quiz, and they can answer the quiz, and then they can record their voices. So I plan to use this activity with them, selecting some dialogues related to the topics we are studying and sharing the link with them for extra practice. And finally, HelloTalk is also a very interesting app for language exchange. I think students will have great fun using language meaningfully with other speakers. So I have already introduced the tool to them, and I ask them to explore the tool. And maybe in 1 or 2 weeks' time, I'll ask them about the results, if they had explored that and what they think. So I'll get to know what they think of the tool and how it worked for them. So I guess that's it. I'd like to thank you very much for sharing all these tools with us and all the great ideas we could read in the forums, discussion forums. And that's it. Thank you very much. See you.